Afternoon. Today is the 8th of October. We are basically discussing the whatever you have covered, but Python is not a computer language in the purest form at C and Java. It is basically the scripting language. You must remember, because why is it scripting language? You can put it from many things. You can put from C++ resource, C resource, and Java resource very easily. It's like a glue type of language. That is the reason it's a dynamic typing, and you can make your program very quickly. That is the reason not other than computer scientists, other people, domain people, like they are very much interested in Python. They can make a program very quickly on it. And right now, Python is right now the very popular language because of it. It is open source. One of the reasons is open source. And one of the reasons it is command is like your English language. It is more real to show any questions. This is today I cover namespace. I think this is almost visible to you, right? Like here, this is the built-in namespace, this is global namespace, and this is local namespace. Remember, you cannot access from here to here, same as a C++ or Java, or here to here. So you can all access from these, from whenever, even local namespace, you can access global or built-in namespace. I'll come what is built-in namespace, but you cannot access from here to global or this. Well, we'll make it clear. The namespaces is basically nothing like a, see, in a class there are maybe two omit. So how to detect two omit? We generally detect by the title, say omit Troy or omit Sen. So namespace is like a title. So it's a very, not very good example. Namespace is nothing but a different namespace, like a summer surname sort of thing. Any? Yes, this is built-in, this is global, you have to declare global, enclosed and local. This is innermost loop, and this is the order. Let's have some, see, this is one code we will try. What is the code? We can directly go to this code first. Anywhere you can see, you can tell me. This is the code. This is the code I am. Yeah. Is this code is visible? Or should I make it bigger? I think it, I make it bigger for. Yes. This code is visible to you? Anyone please? I am running on a this is Colab. What is this is a code right now. The count is a variable. I put it here because the dynamic typing you don't have to say. And this is a, whenever it declares it counts a 5 global, and I another function here I say global count, and then count is equal to count plus 1. So this one is being increased and print count. So this is a method, sum method. Some method is called, and it should be 6, because it is a global count I mentioned. If I should not mention global count, so it will take a, it will also take the 5 values, because global count. But if I take a variable, another count here, that will be, it can be different count, but I say it's a global count. Let's try the command. It's running. Yeah, what is this coming? This is 6. The count 5. Then I'm calling from here. Where I'm calling from? I'm calling the call sum method. The sum method goes here, takes 5, 6, print count. So 6 is print. Then print count. This command will come. I just say the sum method. Then I say print command, another 6. And another time I call 6 sum method. So this is 6 plus 1, 7. So that is the reason 667 is coming. This is, let's see another example. Let's see another example. Actually, another thing I must tell, that Python doesn't have any private, public, protected sort of thing in Java, because Python, everything is public. Okay, everything is public. And if you want to make really private, the private functions name and variable name starts with _ We have seen it _ init _ So these are the private function method variable. So everything there is, so your readability is much more higher. And you know the constructor name is not there. Constructor is _ init, you know. So here it's another def outer function. A is equal to 20, def inner function A is equal to 30. So this A and this A is different. This is outer function A. It is same as a Java also. Print A, inner function, print A. Now A is equal to 10, outer function, print A is equal to 10. Let's try what is the color. So it is coming, see, first I come on A is equal to 10, I have taken, but I am not taking printout. So go for outer function. So it called outer function, then A is first into 20, then go to inner function. A is 30 there, print A 30. So this 30 comes, first 30 comes from there. First 30 comes from there, then inner function A is equal to this A. Which A it is? This is this A, 20. So this A is vanished. So now this is 20. Now it gets out. Outer function print A is equal to. Now this A will be visited. So you are getting the A is outer function. This A is global. A 10 is the outermost. In the outer function A is 20. And inner function A is 30. And it is printed. So basically their object IDs should be different. You know, in Python every variable has an object ID. So they should be different. If you print it here, they might be different. Any question I can answer. So their visibility from the inside, not from the outside. Let's try. Oh, this one interesting. This is a how to call a different namespace. So whenever you call a import math, so there is a namespace. So when every time you call a method, you have to call math dot something, math dot this thing. Import numpy as np is one favorite choice. Then you have to call everything np dot. If you don't do this, then you call numpy dot. So here what I have done. The import math, import numpy, importing the all the, and also namespace also in between. Then I am print, I did math.py. So, and print type.math.py. What is the type? Whether it is integer, definitely float. And print math.py, okay. And this is I print the ID math.py. The same I do for numpy. And we'll see the ID should be different. And because they are taking from different namespace and object type. So if you run this, so if you run, I am running right now. If you see it here, this one is a 560 is the ID of math.py and here is the same py, but it is a different ID. I don't, everybody observe it, this ID is different. So they are basically same value of py. But because they are from different namespace, one is from math.py, that's ID is last four digit is 1560, and another ID is last is it 4640. Is it clear? But their value is same, 3.1415926. So that is the beauty of the namespace. So whenever you are calling a particular import math, then you are calling a namespace, and within the namespace you can have the same name like py, but you have to mention your program py for which namespace, math.py or numpy.py. They are same, but their storage is different. So that is the thing I have to share. And ultimately you see the printed object _ doc, that is will be internal variable, and this is it. Any question here? Any doubt? Should I go once more, please? Please tell, I can go once more. This is a namespace. Whenever I declare, I import a one library, I am I am declaring the namespace, and whenever I taking pi value, the object ID would be different. Okay, so I go to this. So coming back, so here we see the here. So first thing is local. This is local, enclosed, global, built-in. Okay, so built-in it is there. This I have already covered. I have shown you the programming. This is I have already covered outer function, A20, inner function. So from outer you cannot reach inner. From inner you can outreach. So that is the built-in. Same as Java and C++, but one good thing is everything is public here, no private, no protected. Yes, this I have shown. We have this is a, when you create an object or import a module, we create a separate namespace. That is very vital. This is whenever you are importing an object, or this is a separate namespace. You can access the variable using the dot operator. You have to always use the dot. This mat.py and numpy.py values are same, but they are different. Great. Now, just something I should talk, Sarah's discussed about between list and dictionary. List is ON. ON means algorithmic complexity of ON. If you want to find any element into it, you have to search everything to everything. So, if you say N items, you have to look for N, but in dictionary you can get it O1, because everything is named by name, because my name is Shomnath, somebody's name is Amit, and it is hashed. What is hashed? That is, hash function is nothing but such a function which is kind of one-way function. That means if you are hashing my Shomnath, what will do? Say it takes the Shomnath's ASCII values of S, O, N, E, N, A, T, H, add them and make some modulo with 100, and remaining portion in 100 table space, it fixes it. Generally, it is quite a random one. Sometimes the value may conflict, so they take the next value. So, what is the beauty of hashing is, it can be done O1. You don't have to find it where Shomnath is, where this is. So it can be O1 complexity, but remember, list is, if there are 20 items are there, you need 20 space. But in a dictionary, if you have 20 items are there, you must at least have 40 spaces at double the value. Why? Because certain spaces should be vacant, because when a particular object is entered or replaced, it is given by hash value. And it should be seen, if it is a 20 and 20, then there will be chance of collision. If it is a 20, if it is 20 space here, if it is a 21, there is no chance of collision. It is better at least double the value. So, if it is we require the 20 space to be filled it up, so we need at least 40 values or 50 values table for keeping a dictionary. So, dictionary is a space complexity is higher, but the what you gain in the world, you have to forego something to get something. So what you can get, the access time of the key value with O1. You don't have to O(n). That is a great thing the Python has given. Remember, dictionary can contain dictionary. So, dictionary contain a dictionary, that is one thing. And it cannot have duplicate values that you already know. And so it cannot be list is here, because list is, you know, is a mutable. Any mutable thing like list is mutable, like whatever else is mutable, like set is mutable, it cannot be key. So it should be any basic data type which is immutable, you know, that cannot be changed, and that can be key, and values can have a duplicate. Okay, so values can have duplicate values. Say value 1 and value 2 can be the same, but keys cannot be duplicate. So, dictionary may contain dictionary. Dictionary has a great advantage. A lot of problem can be solved by dictionary, because your program is basically program plus data structure. But this data structure is intelligent. Your program can be less. And so, your data structure, if you have a dictionary, you can get a lot of things can be done. Your program can be smaller. any question on dictionary, dictionary can be combined, two dictionary can be union, can be all these set operation can be done. If you see the latest 3.9 Python has released, see lot of good thing have dictionary. So dictionary I think you have all covered. Then parameter passing we all know, just to repeat, in C everything variable is mutable, that is changeable. That means any integer is a changeable. At that time when the C is developed, memory is very, very costly. They cannot afford extra space. But whenever Java, Python is developed, there is a concept of virtual machine. And when a virtual machine, you can throw memory and that will be quicker. But sometimes remember, in Java also, the basic data type is mutable. But in Python, even the basic data type is object, which is immutable. Advantage of immutable is whenever you call by even the call, even you parameter, if you call a function with the immutable thing, that is always a call by value. Because whenever you are sending a variable, that cannot be changed. That's definitely call by value. And if you put certain things which can be changed, like list, like a set, that is a definitely a call by reference. So you don't have to typically remember what is call by value or call by reference. In C, you have to look at it whether there is ampersand or star, and sometimes confusing. But in Java, in Python, you can see the data type which are in the parameter, in the function. If it is immutable, that is call by value. And if it is mutable, like list, like a set, that is a call by reference. Both are required. Say whenever you are streaming media, so most of the whatever you're talking with you, that is streaming media, and there the streaming, and every stream is basically nothing but parallel connection, not it is a serial connection, it is serial communication, though it's high speed. The serial communication, the data should be mutable, okay? So there is a buffer should be mutable, not immutable. If it is immutable, then it should be very slow, because if you high frame of data, it is better it is by the pointer reference in C, and here we can reference it. Another beauty is byte and byte array. I'll cover this. First you tell me what is, you have understood this call by value and call by reference. I think you call value is whenever is a call by value is mutable, and call by references any passed by mutable. Then this is very important. I think this again and again you should remember what are immutable objects, what is mutable objects. One thing I must tell you, what is byte and byte array. Byte is nothing but in Python it is a Unicode. But if you want that very sure that you are using English language, not Japanese language, Unicode is not necessary, then you can go for bytes. And that data type is there. You have to say B in front of it. And difference between byte and byte array is byte array is immutable, byte array is mutable. Same, those who know Java, you know there's a string and string buffer. In Java, string is immutable, string buffer is mutable. String buffer is like C character array. Here you can say byte array also, same as C character array, but only size is 256 bytes, and it will be container is byte. So memory view I'll declare in another class. So byte and byte array is, byte is immutable, byte array is mutable. Why with another data type? Because this will take less space, and because the least take the higher space. So that's it. Any questions? Data type, I think it is visible. This one you can see it's here. Numbers, these are all immutable. Integer, these are all immutable. These are the sequences. Sequences are mutable, is list and byte array. I have told you this is mutable. Immutable, which cannot be changed, like string, tuple, bytes. These can be your key values of a dictionary. Remember, these can be which are unchangeable key values of a dictionary. this one can be key values of a dictionary. Okay, but they can also be the values also, value side also. Immutable means they can be also value side also. But keys can be only immutable side. Set type, frozen side can be key values, it can be changed. There's a typical question in Inter book as what is the difference between frozen set and tuple. Frozen set cannot have duplicate, tuple can have duplicate. Mapping, dictionary you have almost covered, but you have to practice. Dictionary can contain dictionary, and these are things I'll call. Yeah, the same thing, data types, I am taking the views from different places. This integer, long, float, complex, these are all immutable. This is, dictionary is a mutable. Whole dictionary is a mutable. You can add, delete something. Tuple, immutable. Number, immutable. String, immutable. List is mutable. Okay. So, these are the ways. These are the byte array objects I have told. This is byte array. You have to initialize with B, that is byte array. I will cover this byte array. See here, the string BPPMP is this. This is I call this by byte array. You have to, this is the word, and you give 16. Print array 1, and you see the exact BPPMP, and the last value is 00. We can show it right now. We can show it this screen. Any question, you can always make your microphone on and ask me the question. Please ask question, any question. Hopefully, yesterday I got it. Let me find it. Right array. Just a minute. Ask any question, please. I think all are there in the I call at a time. Okay. Last I call. Let's hope. Yeah, it is this. So here we start from there. Here, see, we say a string x is equal to b. B means is a byte. I want to wish to show it in byte. If you don't b, it will take not byte. It will take Unicode. So if you say write it print type x, you see what happens. See, it's a class bytes. This is a class bytes. Otherwise, it will be different type. If you don't say B here, see, if you don't put, you say another copy selection, I just put, say, Y. I put Y, and I say, print anything, you can ask question at any time. Try. One. Yes. Say print. Okay. Print Y also. Yeah. Great. See what happens. See here, whenever you see B, then it is called class bytes. Whenever you don't give B, it is class string. And here it is printed B to show that it is a class bytes. And here string, you don't see S. So that's the difference. I think it is clear to you. Please say, whether, and then I can show once more. What is the different type of byte array and string? Clear? This is bytes. Okay, this is bytes. Let's go to here. This is a triple quote. This is another beauty of triple quote. When in and Python, if you want to give comments, you have to go by triple quotes. And another use of triple quotes is docstring. After the function declaration, docstring. If you just see it here, it is a class bytes. Why? I have mentioned B here. That is a class bytes. And you see the whole, this space is taken by this new line character. Are you getting me? Please, one of you, please say yes or no. Or if anybody? Anyone? Voice is clear? Screen is visible? Hello? 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 Screen is visible?